A little shake-up, I should say. We got a new name for you. It all started from there. Literally that afternoon is when it happened. So, kind of crazy.
What was your thought when you get that name?
You got to be kidding me. That was my thought. Like, 5.3? And then it all made sense once I heard. I mean, I knew it was a thin market this year, and not a lot of teams had money, and you know, with the injury, you know, no, I guess, you know, and Dallas goes and gets DeAndre, and, you know, that would have been a team you thought maybe would go after him, and so he just kind of slipped through the cracks, and in the end, I think it really worked out well, obviously for us, but I think for him too. I mean, I think he's got a chance to really kind of put his career on a new course. Help us, you know. I mean, we're going to need him, and so he can hopefully help us win a championship, and we can put him in a great position for free agency next summer. That's the idea.
I don't know if this is too early to ask, but from him or training staff, have they given you a sense of like what's a realistic return?
That's true. I mean, he wants to play when the season starts. You know, that's his goal. He said he's coming along really well, but I think that's to be determined. You know, we haven't even, our training staff hasn't looked at him. I know he's coming along really well, and it's all very positive. But we're going to be really careful with him. We're not going to rush anything, obviously.
When you got the word, did you immediately in your head start drawing up plays and how you could incorporate?
I did. I started thinking about different ways we could use him. And, you know, I think we can do some of the things that we did with Bogut. Some of the actions that we ran with him, because Bogut was obviously such a great passer, and DeMarcus is a tremendous passer. So I think we can put the ball in his hands either on the perimeter or on the low block. And we've never had a low post player like him. So it's exciting. It gives us the opportunity to play with a new dimension.
What's your initial thoughts of him being with the starting group, bench, or a combination of both?
I mean, you know, once he's healthy, he'll start.
Yeah.
You know, it's nothing against Damian Jones and Jordan Bell, but you know, we're inheriting this all-star center, one of the best centers in the league. He's going to start once he's fully functional and ready to roll.
Have you had a chance to talk to him yet?
Yeah, we just had dinner.
Okay.
Yeah. And
who paid? Great.
What's that?
Who paid?
The Warriors. We both got off free.
Have you guys talked about what might go on?
Yeah, we talked a lot about expectations for each side and how we might use them. We're on the same page. I mean, you know, it's obviously easier in July to talk about how much sacrifice has to be made. But I told him before he agreed to come, when we were talking to him the other day, I said, realize there's going to be 7 straight possessions where you don't even touch the ball because Steph, Clay, and KD are jacking it every time. I said, no, I know. But I told him that, you know, what's unique about our team is whoever's got the hot hand, our guys love to feed that guy. And we've seen it, whether it's Clay, Steph, KD, or even one of the reserves. Our main guys are unbelievably unselfish. All of our guys are unselfish, but it's rare to have superstars who are as unselfish as our guys. And so he knows some nights are going to be his nights, other nights are going to be other guys' nights, but in the end, you know, we're trying to win a championship, and he gives us a better chance to do that.
Did he have any idea?
Yeah, do you know about him as like a shooter, spacer at times too? I mean, like, he can get up and do something.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to discourage him from shooting threes. I will encourage him to get on the block because he's such a great passer. We've always used the post more than most teams, actually. I don't know where we ranked. You probably know where we ranked in post touches last year. Throwing the ball in. You know, post scoring, but actually throwing the ball to hit the post, we ranked pretty high. But we've always done it to facilitate shots from other
if DeMarcus is a starter, do you still see minutes for him of playing with the second unit at times, like through later in the game?
Yeah, I mean, you think about this year, we ran the offense through David West with our second unit, you know, to start the second and fourth quarters. And without having done a whole lot of preparation, that seems like a pretty good idea when Steph and KD are out to throw the ball into DeMarcus, so I can see that happening.
This puts some pressure on you, too, right, to make sure this guy fits in the right way and you keep everything smooth and running.
It's a good kind of pressure.
Yeah.
You know, you always want the pressure that comes with adding great talent. But more than that, I think this gives us a new theme for next year. You know, every year is so different. And I think our team is at the point where our core guys have been doing this for so long. They need challenges. And I think this is a great challenge for us to figure out how to play with DeMarcus. I think our guys will embrace that challenge and they will be more engaged than they would have been otherwise. So,
plus the spotlight's going to be on you as the coach to make sure that, you know, this thing doesn't blow up. You know, everybody stays together, everybody's happy. That's obviously one of your jobs, right?
DeMarcus has the reputation of being an emotional player, but Draymond's been preparing me for this moment for the last several years. So we're good.
With all these like integration questions, like where do you see his relationships with them, with Team USA going into play?
He knows Steph, Clay, and KD and Draymond all pretty well from both the World Championships and the Olympics. And those guys all got on the phone with him. I'm not sure if Clay did. I think Clay was in China. And
right.
So the timing wasn't great. He may not have picked up his phone anyway. Yeah. But, I think the other guys all spoke with him, and they're all excited. And he told me that at dinner that he was amazed how excited those guys were. He's like, you guys just won a championship, you know. But our guys know how hard it was and how hard it's going to be next year. And so to have DeMarcus on our side is just incredible.
Did he express any thoughts on what he might consider ways that you could use him? Like, hey, maybe you could try this with me.
A little bit, yeah. He told me he wants to be a passer. You know, he wants to help facilitate offense for our guys. And we know he can do that. We know he's a fantastic passer. It'll be a little bit like incorporating KD. A guy who is used to having the ball in his hands, but it adds a different dimension than KD. Obviously, KD added more shooting and incredible isolation, one-on-one play when we needed it. But we haven't had this kind of low post scoring threat, so we'll have to find the balance between, you know, continuing to do what we do, spacing the floor, playing with great pace, and, you know, going inside. And and I think he's, because he can shoot threes and run dribble handoffs, he's a perfect player to find that balance with.
Is that it? Great. Thanks, everybody. Appreciate that.
Thanks, Steve. Thank you, Steve.